Hi, behind me is Seeker, a 40-ton ocean research vessel for free. Me and some friends are building it. We are the boat the internet built, and in this episode, we'll be finishing out the walls of our cargo hold.
I'm gonna shave off just a little tiny bit, okay? Let me start doing it.
Well, that's perfect.
Well, this red cedar's looking mighty nice here, Bart.
It is, yeah.
So this is actually Bart's tiny home, and he's using the same wood we are to finish the interior of it. It's going to look beautiful. And he's put a burlap down the ceiling of it. So this started off making a grate for my fire pit, but it's deteriorated into just fun with the plasma cutter. What 12-year-old wouldn't enjoy a little plasma cutting in the evening, huh?
Put that one across all the way down, and we got an even starting point.
Yeah.
There's a nice joint from a 12-year-old.
Well done.
Thank you.
What are you doing here anyway? You got boards put up once you're out of horn.
It's nice having a sewing machine around. I ripped my tool belt apart and got to sew it back up. And we discovered a little spider nursery here. Look at the little spiders out for a little picnic in the park.
Oh man, look at them. Oh my
run
God.
Run away!
It's a ball.
It's a round ball that was in there. And then she glued it on with all this other thread. Okay, we need to check out this spider's address and YouTube channel so that we can get some sewing tips off of her. Did a really nice job on that.
Well, we get better or we get faster. That's it. It's over 100 degrees. Time for a bath.
Oh, yeah. That's going to feel so good.
Oh, this is your skeet shooting shirt.
Well, we can't get a screw in. We just glue it in.
Now we chose to cut our foam and then glue it together with this PL300 foam glue, and that worked real well for us. I mean, but it required the foam being cut very accurately, so you didn't have to use a lot of that foam glue in there. And that gives us the weather barrier. You know, there's no air that can pass through this, so it's not going to have any condensation on the back because you got to have moist air reaching that colder steel. This is an internal bulkhead, but the exterior ones are done the same way. Two layers of this. The furring strips are back behind. But we could have done it another way. We could have used a product like this. This is what you can tape up the joints to the foam with. You wouldn't have to be so accurate because you can buy it wide. And they make various types of it. This one has a nice thicker layer to it. It's all Home Depot stuff, but it's not cheap. It's expensive stuff, so we chose not to do that. But I got this one joint over here that flexes a lot, so I am going to put a piece along there since I have it anyway.
This would be nice to use, but you just can't spend money everywhere.
A little more. Once I get this one up.
It's lunchtime, so I think this one, yes, lovely. Ooh, there.
Okay, get some screws.
It's not as fast as the skill saw, but it sure is a lot more user friendly. Upstairs, I am too. Got a glue stalagmite. a rainy day, but not 105, so that's good. It's little things in life, right?
Yeah.
All right, this will happen to you. Don't worry about it. You can press too hard on the shank. You can get a bad angle. And you can always wear the head out pretty quick. And you'll even snap them off. So expect some losses. Sometimes it'll happen twice in a row. Okay, this is where the fancy miter saw comes in, because it can do a 60 degree scarf along here, which gives us a lot of overlap. So instead of having a butt joint, we have a scarf joint, and that's just a lot easier to do, and it hides it. It also means I don't have to have screws over here. I can just let this board pinch that one back to the wall.
SV Seeker cargo hold, almost all trimmed out too, but certainly all the boards put in. I don't know how many people I have to thank for this. I mean, it started with Max from Australia welding in the studs, and geez, there's been a lot of people since then. Thanks to all of you. You know who you are. Thanks to Wade. Thanks to Ethan. Thanks to Bart. Bart, what are you doing? What are you doing back there?
I'm sitting on my butt.
On the job.
Again.
So we are all done, I tell you what.
Oh, have you seen those doors?
What doors? Yes, the doors came out beautiful. Yes, the lovely archway for the companionway and the what will be the watertight door into the engine room there.
We're kind of curious how much dirt went down below our floors.
Oh, no.
Yeah. That ain't bad. Okay, the bilge is full.
I was just going to say, the bilge is probably full.
But that's not that bad. It's been much worse than this before.
You want the pump?
Nah, we just let it sit
there.
Right. We wore them out. Look at that.
You went the wrong way.
This one's dead.
Well, they're all
behind. Give me CPR.
This string goes in.
All right, the opening to our companionway here is a good place to see the detail. We cut up stainless steel 3/8 inch all thread into short pieces, welded them onto the steel. Then we pressure washed it, painted it with rust doctor to protect the steel. Then we painted it with coal tar, and on the companionway here, this is a Amerilock 2. Then we came back and we bolted on furring strips. These are red cedar boards that were cut, painted on three sides with coal tar epoxy again, and then hammered up against them, drilled through. The all thread then went through the hole, a nut was put on, it was bolted down to the hull. Then we came back and painted this side, the exposed side of the furring strip, with more coal tar. Then we painstakingly cut foam around all of the furring strips and all the structure. Then we put another layer of foam that goes over the top of these furring strips. So there's a furring strip there, it's buried in this layer. This layer just goes on top. It's glued in too, so there's two places where this is sealed to keep air away from this steel hull. Then we came back and put on our red cedar boards. These are 7/8 inch thick boards, and the stainless steel screws go through the board, through the foam, and into the furring strip. So they're just long enough to reach to the back of the furring strip, 2 3/4 inches long, but not long enough that they'll touch this steel and mess up the paint. And that's it, that's all you need. And a lot of volunteers to get it done. We're doing just putting a really hot weld on there, trying to figure out how to weld again. And we've got a piece of pink foam behind it. This is the same pink foam that we used inside the boat. So the test here is to figure out what's a hot weld do to this foam if you don't even bother cutting the foam away. So we're going to let that weld cool a little bit, let it do all of its damage, and take a look.
definitely hot.
Okay, and the answer is?
Whoa!
The answer is you do not want to weld around the foam. That didn't even give off any smoke even. Definitely don't have to worry about fire. And if you just want to replace the foam, that's okay too, but that is something else. Wow. Ethan just laid down a nice hot weld here on cedar, so... look at that.
Nice.
Cedar takes the heat very well. Yeah, you're doing great.
That's gonna
fit.
What's happened?
This is Casa Bart. Oh, look at that.
Yeah, I like this. He's going with vertical boards back in the upper end of the building. Hey, you're doing a better job than we are. You need to mow your yard or we're gonna lose a dog here.
A short one anyway.
I think about 4 full days.
Thank you, Ethan. Lovely fire grate. Now we just absolutely had a wonderful week here with Wade and Ethan. They took off to Texas. You're going to see them on a video from Justin at Good of the Land next. He's going to go down there and do some blacksmithing. You know, I just haven't met many 12-year-olds like Ethan, and so hats off to him and his dad, Wade. We talk about what he does a little bit more on a live video. I'll post a link to that here so you can go look at that. He's actually made some knife sheaths for that have our sailboat on them, and to raise money for our boat. But I think the better thing to do is to buy those from Ethan and let him have that money for it. He wants some knife making equipment. So if you haven't seen our live video and you can tolerate those, go back and look at that. You know, I think kids with that kind of work ethic should be rewarded. You know, it's a much better life than sitting in front of a video game or a YouTube channel too much for that matter. So get busy, guys. What'd you make today?